Get out of it, or is it just...
Keep going. Yeah, there you go. And I didn't know. She left me sleep. And so... I wanted some chicken, and she said,
I said, she's dreaming, so I can play my God. I said, please, Lord, let her be dreaming, because I don't feel like giving. Back out
here. That chicken was good. That chicken was good.
Baby. Chicken and rice.
This morning. This morning.
Yeah.
So yeah. I know y'all had yesterday off. Some of y'all have an extended vacation.
They said, why we keep freezing? That's chicken. Mm-hmm.
They really.
Mm-hmm.
When they realize y'all ain't going nowhere, then they go ahead and leave it. Us alone. That was like
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna try to change out anything.
Mm-hmm. You sure, wouldn't it?
Guys, I want to talk about like going into other people's lives and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe I shouldn't say anything because that might be.
No, it goes back to that question that was being asked.
Okay.
We should be able to.
Okay. Let me ask you a question first. Where is she in here?
Mm-mm, not yet.
Okay.
I haven't seen anybody seen Miss Parks yet.
Is Miss Parks in here?
Miss Parks.
Because those will go hand in hand.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna wait till she get here. So we don't miss her. But that tastes so good. We weren't supposed to really start at 5:30, so Tic Tac probably be through tripping at 5:30.
Baby, you eat your food. Eat your food.
This chicken's so good.
Chili from yesterday. Baby's chili and rice. I don't know what the combination is. I won't be able to understand it. But anyway, she does chili and rice. I made homemade chili yesterday. And then she wanted some. Oh, really? You all off in here? Really?
You were done.
And she wanted me to fry some chicken wings again, so.
Here you go, TikTok. Mr. Ray Cash, you changed your name again.
So I can't ask about the lives then?
Mm-hmm. Oh. Yeah, go ahead. Mm-hmm.
What do you got? I noticed going to people's lives, and it's no, I'm not like talking about anybody. I'm just asking the question because I just noticed going into different people's lives, everybody had different rules. I get it if it's like we got regulars in here, everybody knows. But when you got new people coming in, I mean, something as minor as putting your stuff in all caps, you know, and then you mute people and you block them. I don't get that.
Mm-hmm.
I don't get that.
Mm-hmm.
Been in a couple people's lives and they're like, you know, and I'm like, I was telling Bad, her mom muted me. She's like, well, yeah, what did you do? You put in some emojis? Yeah, but she don't like that.
Man, no.
It's like...
No, nobody knows. Nobody know your rules.
Right. You know. So you should tell the people, don't... Because it must be so-and-so's first time in here. Mm-hmm. I prefer you not to do all caps because some people think you're yelling. I don't know what that is. It's just words. Mm-hmm. But anyway. This individual don't like emojis for some reason. That means that you're spamming.
Mm-hmm.
So if you do it more than one time, you know how we tell you guys to repeat yourself because we want to be able to see what you say.
We want to see it.
If we go into some other people's life and we repeat ourselves, then you get blocked or muted.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just trying to figure. Yeah, she's tearing the food up. Somebody meet me yesterday because I said I want a salad.
Mm-hmm. The thing is about our moderators, they know, you know, they our moderators let you slide on a lot of stuff.
Right.
That's what I do. We wear glasses.
Man, they muted me. I'm like, y'all don't know who y'all, man. Okay, I'm going to tell it.
We had to go in the live.
we had to go onto another phone and go into the live and tell her to tell her mods to unmute.
Mm-hmm.
She didn't say sorry. She just said, well, you know, if you did all the emojis, and that's why. I was just saying, well, I apologize. You know, yeah, my rule is.
Ring up.
You know.
Mm-hmm.
But no.
But nobody got offended, though.
Yeah. Nobody got offended. Mm-hmm. It's just that some people will block and mute you for everything.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you understand, everybody has their own rules, but make the rules make sense. Like, you come in here, if you're being disrespectful, of course, you get muted or blocked.
Mm-hmm.
If you come in here and we actually give you warnings, like on a certain question,
mm-hmm.
you know. But we'll say we don't answer that. But if you keep doing it, then you. But we just don't go around just, you know, the minds just going down the line and just muting and blocking people. So it just, hey Kenya, it just threw me for a loop.
Mm-hmm.
It just threw me for a loop.
I ain't need no cornbread. I'm good with just the rice. Mm-hmm. And not eating my cornbread with milk. I blocked my boyfriend because I blocked my boyfriend because he want to do that go in phone type stuff. I don't get it. What you mean? We ain't got nothing to hide. There ain't nothing to worry about. Right?
Aloha.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Palani, is that your name? Palani?
Palani? Mm-hmm.
Cornbread is better. And milk is better. Cereal. I don't know.
Yep.
Cereal.
Mm-hmm. Cereals.
Cereals, as babies say.
Yep.
Butter, only buttermilk and cornbread swing. Mm,
it don't matter. Cornbread is cornbread. Mm. Why you use two straws?
Kenya, tell them why you use two straws. Just be prepared for the answer.
Because it's dead.
Tell them why you use two straws, Kenya.
Oh, man. Y'all, this is our supper time. In case you're wondering why we always eat when we get on live, because we get on live with y'all during our supper time.
We eat supper the same time every day.
Supper same time every day, 5:30. And so we're going to be eating at 8, 9 o'clock at night and then go lay down.
Which is not good for you.
Yeah. But y'all, we're going to get into the topic in a minute. We're going to get into the topic. I'm just trying to enjoy my food. Can I cut one of your chips?
No. I mean, yes.
If not, if you're going to ask me for a piece of my chicken, then I'll worry.
No, I'm not going to ask for a piece of chicken. I'm going to ask for a bite of your chicken.
I'm take it back.
I want that part right there.
Yeah.
Baby.
Okay,
here.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I ain't gonna do it here. I don't bite my finger. Thank you. It's
she won't let me
do it. She said it's Palani.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I only got this piece of meat, and she's gonna get a big old chip, but yet she can control what I
got this piece right here.
Yeah, your meat was way smaller than that.
Oh. Y'all, let's talk about it. Today's topic is family or foe. F-O-E. I really had to ask baby today what exactly it means, because different terms for or whatnot. But family can be a trip. Family can be a trip. I'm still tripping on that. Family or foe? I'm gonna let y'all start it off, because I don't really know how to start this one. What y'all got? I learned my lesson about being nosy. That's a big starting line.
Family or foe?
I learned or live from a distance. Need TC, yeah, you asked the question. You cannot get offended on the answer. You asked a dumbass question, first of all, and you can't get upset at the answer. Now, the thing is you was answered and you didn't like your answer. So you want to go back and forth. That's a moderator you're going back and forth with. She still chooses to get you up out of here if you want to. It ain't that serious. Hey, Amy.
Is Big B in here?
Not yet. I haven't seen you. Hey, Angela. Family be super messy. They do. Yes, they can. Sister sent the dude I talked to friend request Facebook just to be nosy. Yeah. I let God handle family. Oh, man.
So you do believe that family can become a foe? I mean, obviously.
Yeah.
Or do you still just look at them as family?
I mean, obviously, if they're family, they're family.
Hey, Angie.
Hey, Angie. Family, we'll do that. Go, Big B, right there. Hey. Uh-oh, y'all. Sorry. I'm trying to see if I saw Miss Parks in here. I haven't seen Miss Parks yet. Y'all let me know when Miss Parks get in here. Because we got a whole nother topic on that end. So, yes, they can become full.
Okay.
Family can do you so wrong and cut you off. Yeah. Hey, Pooh 30, 22, she was in there early this morning. Appreciate you for coming through. sometimes you have to love them from a distance. But the thing is the stuff, that's on Miss Fox. Hey, Miss Fox. We're gonna answer your question. Baby wanted to touch on it. She wanted to touch on it. Cause she was trying to school me a little bit too. So, family can, definitely become full. Okay. The thing is some of that stuff that family feel, you know, I'm speaking personally. I don't ask for that. You know, I don't know. How would you? I mean, you don't really have, she don't bother. If I was family folks, she don't bother. I'm trying to get where she is. I'm not there yet.
I'm good.
Why?
I just don't let it bother me because I'm not going to let, I'm just,
look, like I said, I put me first. You're not running my blood pressure up or down. I'm not doing it. Over something that could have been prevented.
But my question is,
I'm not going off of the what ifs. I'm not going to keep going back and forth off of the what ifs. Well, if you would have,
how would I know that a person have a problem with me without them talking to me? I don't find out they got a problem with me until after they didn't address the issue of having an issue that I ain't know they had.
Right, which is what? Not your problem. Not your problem. So why are you going to sit here and stress out over it when, again,
because it all could have been avoided.
Right. That's what I'm saying. You're stressing yourself out over the shoulda, woulda, coulda. They not.
Okay.
That's why I said keep putting more into it than what that person is putting into it.
Mm-hmm.
You're putting more into it. So if they don't care.
Why do family think they should speak on something that. That's not their business.
Like somebody just said, somebody's scroll down. Who was that?
Which one?
Stop. Go back up a little bit. It's just me. Jamie said draining, not worth it. It's draining. It is, because you keep going back and forth and you keep saying, but I know, but why they didn't? Okay, they didn't. So now what? They didn't. But that person did not reach out to me via phone call. I get what you're saying. It could have been prevented. They would have picked up the phone and said, hey, blah, 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 blah. But the point is, they didn't. The fact is, they didn't. So now what? It still don't change.
That goes back to me losing a friend.
Well,
that,
you know what?
I didn't know had a problem.
But you know what? That friend don't think of it as much as you do. So you're putting too much energy into that.
That means I put my all into my friendship.
Well, maybe sometimes you might have to check yourself on that.
So that means I got to be cautious on people.
No, I'm saying you need to check yourself on you. A lot of times you see stuff. A lot of times, like with certain people, you see certain things. Sometimes you don't, and I get that because we didn't see this coming.
Mm-hmm.
But regardless. It's just that my thing is it didn't faze me. It's bothering you more.
Because I was drug into it.
Even if I was drug into it. Actually, I was drug into it myself.
Yeah.
But I'm just not gonna let it worry me. I'm just not.
Mm-hmm. Well, I get you.
Sometimes you have to cut folks loose, even if it's family.
But the thing is, y'all, I didn't know that I had to,
You didn't know what?
Ain't have no more. I get it on both ends. It's crazy. Yeah. I didn't know that, I had to be concerned. I'm saying. No. I did not know.
You're putting too much into it. You really are. And you're draining yourself. You're putting too much into it. The point is, of this particular situation, the point is, it happened. They didn't.
Okay, let's talk about the thing with what Ms. Parks was asking, because
Ms. Parks had sent a message and asked a question. Mm-hmm. How would you feel if, like, a friend told you about yourself?
How offensive?
Like, would you be offended if a friend told you about yourself? And if a friend was honest and told you about yourself, would you guys still continue to be friends?
I would say yeah, because I would say be friend enough to tell me how you really feel. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I mean, I wouldn't be friends if it was disrespectful, but I mean, how offensive is offensive, though?
Did she even use the word? I don't think she said they was being offensive.
I thought
she said they were, if they told you about yourself.
Yeah.
If they told you about yourself, like, just say, Swain, you know you wasn't right. You was low down dirty. You was wrong when you did so and so and so and so. You had an attitude problem and you started it. Are you going to have a problem with somebody checking you for effing up?
Mm-mm. I'm in between the two. What you mean? I can still be the friend, because I want you to be friend enough to tell me your...
Because then your friendship, you're basing your friendship off of what
do you... Somebody said it depends on your delivery.
But still, you're basing your friendship off of conditions. You're saying, well... you know, we can be cool, but as long as you don't tell me about myself, then we ain't got no problems. You know what I mean? I don't want that kind of stuff, but I want somebody to be honest with me.
Be honest with me.
Check me when I'm wrong. Mm-hmm. The delivery, some people, it depends on who you're dealing with.
Like, where you at? A friend should be able to come to you directly and respectfully.
Right. But if, like somebody said, it's the delivery. If you know who you're dealing with, mm-hmm. like if you know you're dealing with Miss J, you know Miss J just come out and just say, she just gonna say it. Mm-hmm. So you shouldn't be offended, because mm-hmm. that's who I am. I'm not gonna skirt around the issue. I'm not gonna skirt around the issue and try to be politically correct, because I need to get my point across. And the only way that I get my point across is I'm direct. I don't believe in doing this to people, because I notice that a lot of people, they don't get the point. They don't get it.
Yeah,
so,
I'm sensitive.
Yeah, hey, but you don't get it when I talk to you like that. But when I do that, what old boy did with his brother the other day, that 1-2 punch. Yeah. I give you that 1-2 punch, you'd be like, okay, I get it. So it depends on who you're dealing with.
Swain is looking for clarity, and she has to stop trying to make sense of what other people think. Again, I was drugged into something that had nothing to do with me.
Freedom of speech includes the freedom to offend people. There go my best friend.
There you go. I'm just saying, I was drugged into something that had nothing to do with me. So yeah, I want to make sure that it's something that I want to. I just want to make sure that it wasn't something I did. And it wasn't nothing I did.
Okay, so now that it's clear that it's nothing that you did, now what?
Yeah, I'm good.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So that's when my dad used to talk, now what? And he'd be like, I guess nothing.
Next year, I'm going to high five.
That's what I'm saying. Stop worrying. Yeah, I mean, and the thing about it is just in general. So if you guys had a friend that came to you, right? This don't have nothing to do with it.
Right.
This don't have nothing to do with our situation. This is something Ms. Parks had asked. So if you had a friend that came to you and basically told you about yourself, mm-hmm. you know, was honest about your attitude or whatever it may be, mm-hmm. would you have a problem? And I know somebody said it depends on the delivery, but if they're speaking facts, mm-hmm. if that was true and they was honest and it was right,
I can accept it.
What difference does it make how the delivery was?
Yes, I elbowed you. I can accept it.
Would you guys continue to be friends? Would that affect your friendship?
And to me, no.
No, it wouldn't either.
Because I'm like you. It's a
two-way street.
Yeah. I'm like this. You was friend enough to be honest with me. Mm-hmm. And instead of having me out here looking stupid to these people in these streets. Mm-hmm. What's going on, sugar mama? I got you.
I'd rather you tell me than tell somebody else.
But the same, I got you. You have to know who you're dealing with and don't allow your trauma to parlay
on you or them. Yeah. Yeah.
Wait, what does that mean?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
She's just saying you have to know, like I was saying earlier, you just have to know what you're dealing with.
I mean,
who you're dealing with, but at the same time, whatever issue it may be, or whatever they're saying, you can't allow that to dictate, you know what I'm saying, the mm-hmm. outcome. You just, basically, you good, baby. You good.
I'm good.
We already know you good.
I'm good.
But, mm-hmm. I'm just saying, I wouldn't be mad because people experience you differently than what you have in your head.
Now that's real. Now that's cool.
People experience you differently than what you,
Because people, I had no idea that this was going to turn way left. Man, dog, that chicken up. I was hungry. I understand what y'all saying. Okay.
Wipe your lips.
Like,
thank you.
I understand what y'all saying. The thing is with me is I felt attacked. I ain't gonna say betrayed. I just felt like I was friends enough, family enough, that you can come talk to me. Not just have a problem and then just cut yourself off from me. I didn't, that didn't sit with me too well. Because now it just makes me wonder, were you real with me from the jump? And then that's what agitates me the most is I wasn't careful in picking and saying and calling that person family. You see what I'm saying? To give you an example, Mercedes, I'm just using it for example. I don't know Mercedes, see what I'm saying? But I love her. I don't know. And then say something pop off. And then it affects me. Well, I didn't expect Mercedes to switch up because it wasn't my fault she switched up. You see what I'm saying? So now I'm having to deal with her switch up and I ain't even asked for it. You see what I'm saying? But I loved her from the jump. We hit it off. We friends. And then one day, boom, we're not friends no more.
But that's beyond your control, so...
I'm just saying that vibe, that...
I know.
That's the part I got to deal with.
I know.
I'm not tripping that person is gone, that person did this, I'm just tripping that I have to switch myself up because I once loved somebody that I thought was in my corner. So, you know, not you, Miss...
You don't have to switch it. I was just... Well, you don't have to switch it. I mean, that person switch. Mm-hmm. You just keep remaining being who you are, and you just keep looking for.
No, I'm not changing me. Okay. I'm staying for that particular person.
Mm-hmm. Hey,
that's all. I didn't think that I would not have to have that person in my life. It's behind something I ain't do. That ain't got nothing to do with me. And I say again. Y'all, stop tripping on a motherfucker that y'all ain't broke bread with. I'm just saying that. If you ain't sat down and had a conversation with these people one-on-one at a dinner table and y'all done shook hands to take care of each other's kids and washed each other dishes and slept in each other, you know, guest room or some shit, stop tripping on motherfuckers you ain't met. So the difference between me and this situation I'm saying is I actually met this motherfucker. I thought this person was a friend and a family. That's all I'm saying. I got that shit dealing with my own family and then come let you in and call you family and you switch up on me now. You kiss my ass. I'm for real.
Okay. So that's what I'm saying. You said it. Right? Yeah. I'm just saying. You said, okay. You said like you said earlier. So you can kiss my ass. So you said, but I'm just saying. You said what you said. So from there.
I'm done.
Okay.
I'm done. Amen.
Hey, y'all.
Hey, Cassandra. I'm all right. I'm all right. This is just me having to regroup on not knowing I had to regroup. That's all I'm saying. Okay. Hey, baby.
I love you, too.
Uh-oh, you mad at me?
I just don't understand why you let people get to you. That's something you really need to work on because that person is at home chilling, feet propped up, doing like this, ain't giving a goddamn. Not a word. And you over here, blood pressure up here.
My blood pressure is not
up.
I'm just saying
you're taking it literally.
Literally. I am because I just felt that was family.
I get what you're saying, my love. Listen to me, is what I'm saying. I'm just saying, give it a second. Listen to what I'm saying. And let it marinate. Let it ponder. Let's just ponder the thought. Is that person is sitting at home chilling?
Did you understand what I was saying, though?
I hear you all the time when you say that, and I have to always let you know that that's why you see me sitting back here just to be like, how are you just so?
I just had to say what I had to say. That's it. Yeah, and that's what it is. And don't be offended or what I'm finna say. But it seems like most of y'all trying to disregard my feelings.
No.
That's all I'm saying. Don't disregard how I'm feeling on a situation that I did not cause. No. So
we're not saying, not disregarding your feelings, right?
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not going to sit up here and allow you to wallow in it and again in it after you said what you said earlier. So I'm not going to sit here and allow that because now you said what you said. Now it's time to straightforward.
What? What you say? One, she would get where you are. Miss J, being around you long enough, it takes time to work. Yep. I understand that. Yes. Just listen and move on. I'm doing it. Drink your Kool-Aid, Under May. I'm doing it.
And the thing is, you guys, okay.
Give another big cup of Kool-Aid. Y'all gonna get off my Kool-Aid.
The thing is, everything has to make sense to baby. What she doesn't understand is that everything sometimes you're not gonna have she wants an explanation for everything. And the explanation has to make sense to what she's needing that for. But in life, there's not gonna be an explanation for everything. There's not gonna be a sorry for everything. There's not gonna be a thank you for everything. There's not going to be.
I don't wanna thank you. No. I don't wanna sorry. No. I'm just saying.
I'm just saying.
I'm going by this
role. Justification. There's never. Sometimes it's not going to be. So
I ain't never sat at the table. And they don't just.
If I ain't tripping.
Okay.
I said, Swing, try strawberry Kool-Aid. No, she don't want no strawberry.
My mama make it, but, you know.
That was hers.
And that's only because she
wasn't strawberry. It was fruit punch. Yeah. Yeah, that was my favorite. Yeah. I think she did it on purpose because she know I
like it. It hurts to let go, but sometimes hurts more to hold on. You're right. I didn't expect it. So. I'm working on me, period. Yes, AP.
Whew. Okay, well, Big B, are you still in here, Big B? Big B sent me a gift. Did you say it was Christmas gift, birthday gift, /birthday/Christmas, whatever? Big B, are you still in here? I want to make sure she wanted me to open this on live. I went and checked the mail today.
She's like, yeah, okay. Birthday? Okay. Okay. Well, we're back to open. So let's see.
Oh, man.
Y'all, I've been emotional for the last 2 days.
Yeah, she been Kenya. She been crying for 2 days, Kenya.
Kenya. Oh, Kenya. Man. I've been crying. The baby look up at me. I'll be like, oh, man.
Yeah, I'll be all down to you right here. Yeah. I'm like, Kenya, man.
Yeah.
I give it an air more. Oh, man. That video from yesterday. Look at this. Come at you. Look at this nut. Big B, I got a question. Why there ain't enough room for both of us in this damn thing? No, I'm just playing. I like that.
Yeah, thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you so much.
I just want to put it across you right here. Because you know I'm bad. You know it. Hey.
Don't stop till you get enough.
You want to do a video with me? What? You tired?
I want to run again. Thank you, Big B. I appreciate you so much. I would like to thank, pay honor to God and my family and everybody out there. I just want to tell you guys, we really worked hard to get to this point. See y'all next year. Thank you.
I sent you. She had a hard journey yesterday, but we gonna see. Keeping it real. Yeah, thank you.
I appreciate it.
Oh, man. Send baby the tracking number. Inbox and send her the tracking number. She'll be on the lookout for her.
Thank you. And I know you said that Big B, that you sent Swing something, and hers will be here
Saturday?
Yeah, so I got the tracking number for that. So thank you so much.
Yeah, Miss J. Bay. Yeah, you bad.
Yeah. Yeah, thank you so much. Mm-hmm. And, you know, like I always say, and I told Big B this, I told her, I said, you know, we don't ask for nothing. We just appreciate you coming into life. Thank you for your love and your support. Mm-hmm. You know, I know people work hard for the money and times are hard right now. So, you know, we don't be looking for anything, but I appreciate just the thought. So thank you so much.
But you can send me anytime and I'll be fine.
You're getting your word Saturday. Saturday?
Saturday. Yeah. Hopefully I get my truck back, y'all.
Yeah.
I will send the tracking information. Okay, thank you. Keeping it real. 3-3-1-1. Don't get me excited. Love being here. This is what we do.
That's what we are at time now. Wait till we get to one of those where we laugh a lot.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Okay.
Then we have some that we actually cry a lot on.
Yeah. Anybody want to get in the guest box? We're going to try it. Anybody want to get in the guest box? We got about 15 minutes. Anybody want to get in the guest box? Come through. Be respectful. Give two minutes. And please have a picture so we know we ain't dealing with no kids.
You want some crawfish?
You gotta wait till end of May. I mean, the end of April.
We're in Texas.
Yeah. That's when they come back in hard, when they're coming in, at the end of April, beginning of May. That's when they real small right now.
Hey, mm-hmm. Auntie Dana Dane. Mm-hmm. So nobody wants to... You coming? You come? Where you coming?
Coming to Texas?
You coming to Texas or you coming in the inbox? Which one?
Get in this box. Hi, what's up, Nikki?
Hey, Nikki. Nickelodeon.
She's from Texas. Okay.
Yeah.
You see, we talk like we twins. You see how we say
Man, moving to Dallas, Texas in June.
Wow, okay.
Okay. Okay. She said, oh yeah. first concert was Jackson 5.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, Bonnie. I like the outfit
you have on today. Thank you. We just lounging around the house.
Yeah. These are our lounging outfits.
Yeah.
Isn't that nice, though?
Yeah. So.
My goodness.
I appreciate y'all, you know, being friend enough to tell me the truth and tell me how you really feel. And I accept it and receive it in love.
I really appreciate Miss J coaching you. And don't worry. And be happy. Live and let go.
Yes. Yes, I appreciate y'all. And y'all can tell me how y'all feel. I'm sensitive, but I'm all right. My freckles are eyes, so I'm staying
in my body. Okay. Your freckles are beautiful. Just like baby's freckles are beautiful as well. She's got a lot of freckles, too.
What? You gonna do my hair?
I was gonna ask you a question.
Ask me a question. Go ahead.
Well, I was gonna ask you a question.
Ask me a question. I can take it.
That's what, not you. It's asking you about them.
As well. Ask. Go ahead. I can.
No, I'm just gonna say. Are we gonna talk about the? Or not yet.
Yeah.
What when you talking about this morning when you say would y'all pay for it or?
Yeah.
The service.
Ask.
Okay, you guys, we have a quick question.
Yeah. Just hypothetically. Yeah, hypothetically, you know.
If we started doing a couples coaching,
right.
Coaching couples,
yeah.
Would you guys attend? Like the individuals who are couples and you're having, you know, need coaching, would you attend? That's one question. I'm gonna see how many people say what they say first.
Alright.
So we did a couples coaching.
So I got a question
individually.
On that. I got a question on that.
Uh-huh.
So say, because everybody's saying yeah. Now it's couples coaching, but mm-hmm. only one is attending, or do both have to attend?
Both have to attend.
But what if they're a couple,
right?
But it's always that significant other that don't want to participate, but that person wants to figure out how to get them to engage. But they in a relationship. They're not single. You see what I'm saying?
Okay. So, I mean, well, we prefer to both, but like you said, and it would be online. It wouldn't be in person just due to the pandemic. It wouldn't be in person. So it would be online. My next question, because a lot of people are saying yes.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody said, what is your rate? there would be, because that would be our time.
Right.
It would be, it's in talks. So it would be a fee. We don't know what the fee would be, but.
Yeah, this is all hypothetical.
You're right.
That's my scenario for sure. Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, because a lot of people are in a relationship where their significant other is not participating, but they would love to talk to us
mm-hmm.
to get us our view on a certain particular situation on how they would handle it.
Right.
So,
and then, you know, the thing is, it would be a fee because in that way your money's, you know, first of all,
it's one on one.
Yeah, it's time. And then at that, you know, we don't want anybody coming in and doing like this. Because we have people do that. The way they just come in and start staring.
I'll take insurance.
Blue Cross Blue Shield.
Oh,
but,
man.
I want to do it. We just say I want to do it, but by myself. And the thing about it is not to get in and start like asking questions about us or trying to befriend just swing or trying to befriend.
It's strictly pertaining to you.
It's just pertaining to you
and your situation.
And you come in and I come in staring because some people they was coming in staring when we did the meet and greet. You know, you come in and say,
but see the difference is with the meet and greet. I put in a lot of time.
Yeah.
And didn't nobody show up.
Right.
The thing is this time you will be paying for it. So if you paid $40, $50, that's on you for 30 minutes and 45 minutes. Because it would be like a 45 segment with just us one-on-one.
Yeah.
Just giving a ballpark mm-hmm. or whatnot. You know, you pay for it, then it won't be wasted time. You right. see what I'm saying?
Would you say it's coaching on life issues? I mean, pretty, you know.
We need a coaching relationship.
Yeah, coaching micro yeah. relationships. Yeah,
because we that's mainly what we can't on. Tell you what to do, how to, you know, live your life. Only mm-hmm. you can live your life to the best. It's called experience. I'm putting in a meet and greet for TikTok in Georgia.
Okay.
If you pay, you commit. Exactly.
That, and see, a lot of people, they will.
Yeah.
Because a lot of people said, we got a lot of people that said that they would show up for the meet and greet. I mean, a lot of people mm-hmm. on the lives were saying that. And then when it came down to it, only like 3 people would show up out of 20.
Man, I had 20 people apiece. We had a boatload of emails. And when I tell you, I got off work. And just came in and was sending everybody emails and invitation, and only 5 people showed up out of 40 each day. And it was just I did it for the May, for Mother's Day. I did it each weekend.
See that? You got played.
Man, thank you. You got played. Man.
And the thing about it was babe's time, because she's putting together all the emails and sending out, you know, making sure that she's getting everybody and not repeating
because
people.
Because I'm a person of my word.
And then people would come in, and then they would come in. Now, we had some people that would come in that came talk. In, and they talked because other people that was in there was like this.
Latrice talk.
Well, we know Latrice talk.
Pretty Miles talk. I see her face is in. I can't come up with her name. Like, oh,
Smitty talk, right? Smitty was in there. Was that
Smitty? Yeah, Smitty talk. Who else was it? Miss Lynn talk.
Yeah.
You know, we know the ones.
But they was in separate groups, so yeah. there was that one out of, you know, yeah. out of the 3.
Out of the group.
You know, out of the group that did all the talking, and they was like, well, they ain't saying nothing, so they took advantage of the time.
He said, I talked.
Oh, yeah. So they took advantage of that time, but then we just had people just say, I'm glad to be here.
Keeping it real, say, I have no problem paying $50 for 45-minute session. You know what? Give me some. Just give me some.
Mercedes said, just nosy.
Yeah. Oh, man.
So.
I came to too late to join on the part. It's all right. It's all right. You register right. and pay first years will participate. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And that's, that. I mean, like we yeah. said, it's just something that's up in the air. We yeah. haven't said for
we're
sure.
We're just trying to figure out how to go about it.
We're just trying to figure out the ins and outs about
yeah.
it.
Yeah. Yeah. So. That's what I'm talking about. because, yeah. I'm real person of our word. Our DJ, we don't need no music.
She said she getting in somehow.
Oh, man. But yeah, remember this morning yeah, when I was talking you. About trying to figure out how to retire, how to stop driving, mm-hmm. you know, and still have, you know, money come in. You know, it's just feel like it's a good idea, you know. A lot of people love talking to us, but they want to talk to us on one-on-one.
Right.
It'd be confidential. We ain't going to discuss yourself with anybody else. But you got to be...
And this is all based off of because we have been seeing for the past couple of months. It's been maybe over a year. But people just get into baby's inbox and want to ask advice. Well, you're giving away free advice.
Mm-hmm.
You're giving away free time. That's your time of going back and forth, back and forth, back and forth with people. And mm-hmm. I mean, people are sending stuff over, and I'm like, no, no.
She stopped
that. That comes to a stop.
Cause I'll be talking back. I mean, like, yeah.
Yeah. No, that comes
and
to a
like,
stop. No.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So that comes to a stop. Just FYI. So no more inboxing and yeah. answering questions. If you have a problem, then we, you know, what have you. Then we need to sit down and do coaching, and because the wording is very important, so coaching on that issue, you sit down with the both of us. You can't have just a one-on-one with me or just a one-on-one with her.
Right.
It's with both
it's
of
with
us.
Both of us.
So,
yeah. Unless I'm at work, I mm-hmm. mean, I'm not just excluding at all, you know. But mm-hmm. you know, if I'm at work, I'll be on FaceTime on another phone with her, but you won't get an alone time thing. Well, let me delete my paragraph.
Between you and baby, y'all sent some paragraphs.
Yeah, I like talking.
Look,
I like talking.
Look, me, this is what I do. Like.
And it burns me up too, boy. I was like, ah, damn, you ladies can also do master class that would generate nice income because you have good content.
Who said that?
Mackenzie.
Mackenzie?
Yeah.
Okay,
Mackenzie. What's your dream with retirement? Just to be at home. I just want to be at home. Honestly, you just got to understand, I know y'all try to get tired of hearing my story, but I worked so hard and I've just had to fight all my life. And I just want to just be home. I don't want to fight.
Really?
I want to be content. I just want to be...
You know what? Let me tell you something about me, Kenya. I read it, right? I'm a person of...
She skimmed
of
it.
Of... No. I've read it. Like, even if you send 5 or 6 sentences, I read it. But my thing is, I'm one of these people where less is more. You see what I'm saying? I don't do the unnecessary...
Write me
unnecessary texting back. Like, baby, like, you can say, all right, good night. And I can type back and say, good night. This is baby. Okay, good night. Tomorrow's going to be a great day. You get down on your knees. You pray. I had a good dinner this evening. I had chicken, rice, lettuce, and tomatoes. And cheese. And
yes.
I swear,
I like
this evening,
talking.
The temperature was 60 degrees. And it's like, baby, say good night.
I like talking.
And then what happens is that when the person get the text back, then they come with this long thing.
Yeah.
And then she go back. And I said, wait a minute, stop.
I like talking.
Stop. She don't like talking because when I get to talking, this is what she do.
Hey, wait. Y'all can always tell which one of us you're talking to.
No, because sometimes I trick them.
I'm just saying. Y'all can always tell.
And if you notice, I switched up. I tell you, I switch up on people.
No, I'm just saying.
What have I switched up?
Sometimes, like yesterday.
I switch up. You don't never know what you're gonna get.
I like talking. You will know it's me because I like to talk. That's all I'm saying. Oh, she's acting like Kermit the Frog on the typewriter. You gotta understand. I don't talk on the phone. Don't nobody call me. You know, family is not family like they used to be. And so I did. So when somebody's talking to me, shit, I talk. So I'm just saying
when it's necessary is what I'm saying. When it's necessary, it's not always necessary.
She can say that she still got the 2-3 friends, family, and cousin, and mama, and she got all the people to talk to.
Yeah, sure.
I just got my mind.
Yeah, that's why I am. But due to I'm a technical person, a technical support person, everything is short to the point. Just get to it and get to the next call. So I've always applied that to also my life as well. That everybody don't want
to
hear that.
Talk. That's all. You may not be licensed therapist, but experience, advice given. Being
so uplifting
and on point. Yes. So y'all, we're gonna talk it over. We're gonna come up with a price of it. We definitely know it will be 45 minutes a session. We gotta figure out how we're gonna.
We just gotta figure out the ins and outs.
Yeah.
Of it all. If it's gonna come to. If we actually agree to do that. So that's hey Bree K. That's what we're working on. Okay. Yeah, we'll let you know.
Hey, Chevy on top. I love talking on the phone. I'm talking. It's just, nobody call me. Nobody call and talk to me. The people that do have my number. I got a bestie right now who only call me when she ain't heard from me. Then she be like, okay, I'm just checking on you. And then boom, I don't hear from her again, you know. All right, let's say keep them posted. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. I'm excited.
Yeah.
$50 for 30 minutes. I say 45. That's a lot. 45. I would say
45.
$50 is a lot, and a lot of people not working, and it's hard to come across that, you know, I'm in that situation, you know. So, we not want to take advantage. So, wow.
Thank you again, Big B.
What'd you say? I'm with you. I get happy when the spam caller call.
Oh, Would that mean your answer?
May you come in alive. Yeah, you come in. Give it 2 minutes. Give it 2 minutes. We don't turn nobody down.
Who's
just,
that?
I don't know. Just,
Baby, I don't know. She won't even look
just
at the
come
name.
In. Just come through. Okay, I miss what you guys doing. We ain't doing nothing. If you do this, any topic is off limits. No topic is off limits.
Yeah.
Just be willing to accept what's being said. You know, because if you come in talking about Polly and we don't have no, we don't deal with Polly, you done spent $50 for nothing because we can't speak on something we ain't experienced.
We're going to need to know the topic ahead of time.
Yeah.
Just to, you know, prepare. So.
Make sure you ladies have a strong disclaimer up front. No widows will be lucky. Yes.
Yes. Mackenzie. Who are you behind that picture, Mackenzie?
Oh, man. I'm just saying.
Mackenzie, you got any contracts that we need to be, like, need to send over our way so we can print up and sign?
I'm just saying. It's a lot of things that we haven't experienced. Yeah, and you
she
may...
says fun.
And we don't want to, wait a minute, hold on. We don't want to tell you we don't talk about it, and we don't have no experience in that area. So I would advise you to be, you know.
That's why I said we know ahead of time, so that way we know how to prepare for it, and if that's not our expertise, or, you know, we haven't had any experience in that, then we can, you know, say, hey, that's not something we've, you know, had experience in.
Yeah. Kind of all, but did y'all do the link? Yeah, the link tree is on both our profile.
Yeah.
Just go to our profile, mine or hers, and just press on that link tree, and it give you all of our sites that we're on, and it'll, what's on? And it'll, which one?
Go some more.
Keep on?
Yeah, okay. Right there. Okay. You do a questionnaire email with the client, and they answer questions about themselves and the topic. Got you.
Okay.
That's a good suggestion. See, That's the thing is, we're just trying to get some
tips.
Get
a feel on it. Yeah. Go on the bio on both our pages, because she has hers and I have mine, and just press on the link tree, and it'll take you to all our platforms that we're on.
Mm-hmm.
So
that way, you know, it helped prevent us from having to do it at the end and missing something or giving you the wrong
info.
Because I know a lot of you guys were having problems finding the Facebook page.
Y'all made it all cute and stuff. Yeah. You see,
that's baby. Baby did that.
I did it.
Yes, she did. When she said swing J Ink.
Oh, man. As a licensed professional, forgive me, but it's a little offensive, but I love your content. Why you say that?
What's
offensive?
A little offensive?
What's offensive? Because she's licensed. Because she's a licensed professional.
Yeah. Right.
But we're not trying to offend you.
But you're licensed professional what? Therapist?
Yeah. Okay, can you talk about starting back day and when the question... What should I can you do topic on people starting back dating and what questions to ask on a date? Okay.
Licensed professional. So I'm just trying to figure out what's your title? What's your title?
Yeah. We're not trying to step on nobody's toes though, you know, but you know, yeah. Okay.
That can be tomorrow.
We can do that on tomorrow.
Start back dating and what questions to ask on the date.
Yeah.
And again, you know, that's good. I think that's a good topic.
Dating after 50, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Last circumstance, experience best friend, looking to see advice.
Mm-hmm.
Good old common sense and spirits take you a long way. Yep. Just as good as a therapist. You can do this in many ways, but it's easy to get certified. Yep. Mm-hmm. Yeah. We're going to be on live tomorrow at the same time. Sometimes it depends on what happens tonight. If I get on in the morning, y'all know how I do. I'm licensed in children's behavior.
Okay.
Some get certified in a day. Okay.
Okay, you're licensed in children's behavior. I can see that. It's just that
we're talking grown people.
We're talking, like we said, what we do right now. We talk about life experiences, what we've been through, what we would do in a situation. That's what we do.
Mm-hmm.
We never, and we always do a disclaimer at the end saying we're not licensed therapists
or life coaches, you know.
But however, you know, looking into some things, this would be an arena that we might, you know, move off into.
So, again, this is not to step on anybody's toes or...
I mean, you guys have to look at it like this. We talk to you guys on a regular basis.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of you guys say, hey, you've helped me.
Mm-hmm.
We come in here, we have conversation. We just sit down. We sit down and we just have a conversation going back and forth. We bounce ideas off of each other. And you guys talk about how we helped you in a relationship, mm-hmm. not knowing that we did by saying certain things until you guys inbox us and tell us, or on the live you tell us that, and help you get through some things.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're we do that not knowing that we do it. Yeah. Well, just imagine what we can do when we put more effort into it on one-on-one.
You know, because we've had someone get in here and tell us how we saved their life.
Hey, D Hunter.
We have people tell us how we saved their life. And I know I dealt with depression and almost taking myself out of here, too. So I can speak on that stuff. But I shouldn't have to, you know, go sit on somebody's couch and pay $150. I'm not doing that.
Or actually, you shouldn't have to go and get licensed. Just because that's no different than me talking to one of my friends on here, and then I'm giving her advice. I shouldn't have to have a license to give her advice on my life experience.
Yeah,
we're talking the best experience is life experience. You know,
what you say, you guys are going to make a difference, and you small $50 fee is way more cheaper than my $275.
Well.
Oh, y'all see, y'all understand what I'm saying then.
It's just the point of that you have we have the following, and we all get in here and we talk. And the thing about it is we all help each other out when we, you know, all the way up until now, we all help each other out, you know, how we feel about certain things. Like, well, girl, yeah, tell him. And then some people say, no, don't tell him. And we're like, yeah, tell him, you know. So we all help each other out. And so... I just know, I didn't know that we inspire and help a lot of people out until we went back and looked at certain things and seen it in black and white.
You're my antidepressant. you don't realize how many people you helped survive the pandemic. I'm grateful for you helped me. Thank you. Oh, thank you, Mackenzie. Oh, man. Dating tips for widow. I was married for 22 years. Okay. Yeah, it shifted me when somebody told me that we stopped them from trying to take their life.
Well, too, when it comes to children behavior, what'd you say?
Did I say?
Damn it, I have four kids.
so it just feels good to hear those words that, you know, something I've said or something we've said,
mm-hmm.
to pull them back, mm-hmm. off that ledge. And if, you know, if I can do it one-on-one, I'm cool, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And again, we're not trying to take advantage of nobody, you know? I'm going to just say it. As I said, it's bloodless and blade if I need to. But baby don't need your money. Baby don't need it. I work. And I like providing for my family. And if I'm going to stop driving, I still got to get paid. So, that's about as plain as I can say it. Huh? Yeah.
There's a gift in you to use it.
Yeah.
Seriously, in the beginning until you get established, accept love.
Love gifts.
Love gifts instead of payment.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But again, I have to be able to provide for my family mm-hmm. and keep the lights on and stuff. You know, I have her, but again, you know, I just feel, you know, I ain't gonna say responsible. What's the word? I don't feel responsible, but I like
providing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So,
yeah. And the thing is, I mean, we spend more time with you guys, talking to you guys about different, you know, mm-hmm. issues. And
I make it a point to get off and get here on time. You have every right to coach whoever you want that services from y'all. Right, yes.
Right.
Thank you, keeping it real. I wish I knew who you were. Is that? Thank you so much.
We need to see a picture. Let's see a picture.
Yeah, bless my life tremendously. Thank mm-hmm. you. I just never thought I'd
But you guys don't know how you helped us too. Just was, you know, when we're asking and we ask for a certain advice. Sometimes we don't ask, we just making a statement and then you say, well, no, Ms. J, it's this, blah, blah, blah. Even though I'd be like, well, I'm, you know, but we go back and forth. But at the end of the day, we still appreciate you guys and the advice that you guys give us because we go back, like we said, and we look at the live, we look at the comments, we'll sit in bed, look at the comments and be like, I never thought about that. Yeah. I didn't see that comment early. I wish I would have seen that. I would have responded. So we pay attention.
Nat Porter, we don't speak on anything medical. We don't speak on anything religion. We don't speak on anything monetary rise, only because everybody, politics, everybody's not going to agree.
Right.
And so we don't speak on those things that's going to be controversial.
We stay away from those arenas.
Yeah, that's going to be controversial. Right. So whatever you decide that's... We just
do it for you.
Yeah, some things we just don't touch on or talk about. Let's see.
Yeah, so we just appreciate you guys coming in here, like I said, and showing love and support. We all, just like I was telling Mercedes, because she's like, I like you here, that we've all had our, man, y'all, we had lives where we all cried.
Mm-hmm.
Where I bust out crying and y'all have cried and baby have cried. We all cried. And we all have our lives where we just be cracking up. We don't even know. When we look back, because Kenya captures those moments.
Yeah.
And
she's
then
been
we look
crying
back,
ever since.
And I'm like, what were we laughing about? I'm like, we were laughing so hard and we being alive and you can see us going. And we don't even know what we were laughing about.
Oh,
but
man.
Kenya, thank you for capturing those moments, because I'm going to tell you.
She's been crying ever since.
Every since. I don't know what it is about this particular one, because here it come right now.
Yeah.
Ah. But whatever this particular one, it moves me.
She loves the song. She's going to do the song.
I'm going to do the song. I love the song.
Yes.
And I done played it. I done, huh?
Oh, wait, I'm trying to catch for a fall.
I played the video.
I'm team time.
I don't even know how many
times. I took a nap this morning and I woke up and the song was still playing.
I love it.
Yeah.
So.
What is it called? You move, I move. I move, you move, something.
I don't know. Well, all I know
John
is
Legend.
I love the song, and looking at the video, I'm just like,
yeah,
it just touches me. Oh, I tried to catch it. I got it. And every time I see Kenya, I cry like it's the first time I'm seeing it. I don't know what it is. So hopefully I'll be able to hold myself together doing the song.
She said, somebody said they want to play it. Let me play it right quick.
You want to play the video? Oh, you want to see the video?
Yeah.
The video is lovely.
Yeah. Hold on. Let me get it.
See, I'm going to start crying.
Don't start crying.
You got it turned up?
I am. Hold on.
But I'll pick you up and put you back on your feet. Oh, that's how this works. I put you first. Yeah, I do for you what you want me to. When I'm lost, you give me heart. Pull me back and push me forward. Take me in and hold me.
Kenya, you did that. You did that.
Yeah. She told me, she said, I hope you like the song.
I love that freaking song.
Yeah.
I love it.
Thank you, Kenya.
And every time I look at the video, I just cry. Just cry.
Whew, do you ever come to Louisiana? I'm in Louisiana all the time. When I'm at work, I'm usually in Chalmette. I'm at Breakway.
Pull out the tissue.
Lake Charles, I'm always in there.
Thank you, King. Yeah, I mean, go to, if you guys go to Swing Therapy One Instagram page, because she has it listed. I mean, she has it on her page. Yeah. And
it's the first video that you see.
I love it, and I'm going to watch it probably about 10 more times, because I'm trying to learn the song, too.
Yeah.
I just don't know how it's going to come out. I cry every time I hear the song. Yeah. So.
Yeah, that's how I was with that Love You So Much.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I love You So Much, but for some reason, this one...
It's a new one, yeah.
I don't know what it is.
New. It's new, and it's When You Move, I Move. Because when I move, you
move. Because that's like, it's us.
Yeah.
Kenya did that.
Yeah.
You did that, Kenya.
Yeah, so.
The words touch your heart. Yes. Yeah, they do.
When I move, you move. Yeah. I felt the song fit y'all.
Yes.
Yeah.
Because one of the other songs that you had, I don't know.
What?
Remember that one piece?
I was like, why is that like that? Yeah. I was like, no, I don't like that one. Sound like we dead and like we had a funeral or some
but
shit.
You just have a shh. But can I ask you a question? I mean, can I ask you a question though? Like, how much footage do you have?
I don't care.
No. I'm just asking because, like, how far? I'm trying to figure out. Do you know when you started recording it?
Mm-hmm. I don't know, cause she got it from the beginning.
She got some archives, and so I'm trying to figure out how far back she go. Cause if she go far back, then I'm thinking.
Yeah. All I know is
how far back do you go? Do you know?
We use Kenya to do our topics and stuff. When you see that we make the what the topic's gonna be, she be the one that's making that for
us.
She's
the one that does all the graphic.
She said August 2020.
Okay.
Just the beginning, yep.
wait.
Oh, man, yep. You are so sweet.
You're going to get tired of me. Okay. Oh, wait a minute. Hold on.
Oh man.
So Kenya does he's so silly. She does all the graphic work
for
us as far as the lives and the topics. So when you see it on Babe's page or my page lately, that's Kenya that does that.
And
the collaboration of videos that she puts together, like what you just seen. Yeah. She does that. And she just out of random, she just send something over and say, hope you like it.
Yeah.
And then we see, we be like, God dang, she outdid herself. And we be in bed crying. Can we post it? She's like, sure. So that's, and I know that's a lot of, and I know.
I appreciate it.
This one right here, Expectations, and you know, she wants you to
do it right then.
That's why when you say, I have something for her, I'd be like, oh, please don't tell her you got a video, because then she said, wants a video like that.
I love that song. I'm going to do that for my wedding anniversary in August.
Okay.
She said 611 videos, y'all, but then you talk about my damn contacts. She's talking about my contacts. Yeah.
Oh, I'm so excited. I have to tell you why later.
She said that's different.
Yeah, it is.
600 is 600.
Because those are 600 some different people. She just got of us.
Oh, man. Y'all just do that for us. Y'all cannot take our person away from us. She's going where we go.
Yeah.
She's going with us.
I said when we are putting in the universe, let it manifest. When we
elevate
and make
it. She's elevating with us.
I told her that's our That's our system.
PR
that's
right there. That's PR our PR right there.
Make, you just pack up Junior. Bring Junior with you. Pack up Junior. Bring Junior with you.
Yep. Yep. So that's our PR person right there. So when we elevate, she elevating with us. So,
yeah.
Anything
so.
Else, buddy?
No. I mean, that's I think we addressed everything. Pretty much addressed everything. So yeah.
So all the platforms that we're on, just go to our bio and press on that link tree, and all of our. She said the whole time he a Junior for real. And the link tree will direct you to all our platforms.
She said, okay.
So I appreciate y'all listening to me, and I heard y'all, and I'm okay. And I will be okay. I'm good. And I love y'all. But don't y'all switch up on me. I can't go through this shit no more. I ain't doing this again.
We love you.
I love y'all too. I love, especially you. I love you.
I'm sorry. Y'all, I do that all night. I can't wait to take my makeup off. When I take it off, I'm like...
Hello, and I
that way she have to worry about my face coming off.
Yeah, I thought her face came off, y'all. When I first kissed her, I didn't know about the foundation and makeup and stuff. So when I kissed her and I went in the bathroom, I said, wait, baby, your face is... your face. What happened to your face? Your face is on my face. I didn't know nothing about foundation. I didn't. I ain't know. I thought...
And the question was asked... The question was asked yesterday was... So when she first kissed you, like, what was your response? Like, how did you respond? Did you? I said I was like, whoa. I said, but then I was like, wait a minute.
She was crying.
We got something here.
She was crying. She was crying, and I ain't know what else to do. So I just did what I knew to do, and women like to be kissed when they crying. So
that's
I just
not
kissed
true.
Her.
Where'd you get you
y'all,
watch y'all so much movies?
Y'all like to like, and so. And I didn't, you know. So, and I was just saying, either she gonna slap shit out of me and go and that be it was well worth it, or she gonna like it and stay. She stayed, y'all. So I'm just saying, I ain't never seen it. So
my
baby's
not a girl, and I'm not gonna do her makeup. No, that's a no go.
It was all on my face, and I said, baby, your face. Your face came off. And she thought it was the funniest thing, but I was serious. I ain't know. Your face came off, baby. And look, when I came back in the room, it didn't look like you messed up. Like, did you powder up while I was in the bathroom? Come on, touch
me. I just don't know. I just know what I'm doing. Get up off me.
Oh, man, that live with 2K was real quick. What you say was a real girl chat, hot topic. She was like, I am too nosy. I don't know. I was sleeping with 2K when you had that conversation with 2K.
Uh-huh.
Okay, I was asleep, so I didn't know.
Yeah, I got into her live, and she was asking about, you know, our relationship and just asking, like, how did I know? But you know, like...
That, you didn't.
That you was the one, you know, and she I was did. Just explaining to her that I didn't go out, I didn't seek you out, you know, I didn't do that. It was just, it
she
just happened.
Just come to all this greatness over here. She ain't know about all this greatness.
Yes, indeed.
Ooh. All that greatness.
As Mercedes too. Said, okr.
Oh, man. So I'm just, wow. I'm like, wow.
Yeah. So, I mean, hey. I just know one thing. I wouldn't change a thing.
Me neither.
I wouldn't change a thing.
I'm at my highest of highest levels of happiness. And I thank you for that. And thank you for being my peace.
Well, I mean, like I told you time, y'all, here we go. I told you time and time again that she came into my life. Like, she came at the right time when I needed her, even though she didn't know that I needed her and I didn't know that I needed her, but she gave me what I needed at that time.
That's
and not talking about physically, you know, like sexually or anything like that. It was her just being there as a listening ear. And just being there for me, not knowing that I was grieving, still grieving, my husband, my dad. So she was just there for me. And then we just got to chit-chatting and chopping it up. And then, you know, we was friends and talking every day and for hours. And the next thing I know, I'm on the phone with her for about 5 hours straight to make sure to make sure that she got from point A to point B driving.
Yeah.
And that's how we, you know.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. So
I appreciate that.
Appreciate you.
Just being my peace. I just wanted peace. I just wanted hurt and oh man, I was in so much pain. I was in so much pain. But I was smiling through it all.
Mm-hmm.
And when you came through just talking to you, my spirit.
Mercedes said God said it is time.
It was my spirit, you know. And I was like, oh, because I wasn't attracted to you physically. Not that you weren't bad looking.
So there you go. Somebody said it was a love at first sight. Yeah. So it wasn't
I wasn't attracted to her physically, although she looked good. But I had been in so many relationships but based on how somebody looked. So I stopped looking at looks. And so when I stopped looking at looks, I didn't think that a person could be beautiful on the inside. And so when my spirit felt her, I was like, wow. I didn't want you to go. Tell them what I did when you did leave.
She followed me. When I told her, I said, well, I gotta go home. I didn't have to come. But, you know, I came home because I was visiting her.
Yeah.
She was like 4.5 hours away, 5 hours away. And I said, I gotta go. And then she's like,
I'm packing my clothes. She's like, where you
going? Next thing I know, she come outside. She's like, all right, I'm going to follow you. I was like,
but I wanted to make sure she got home safely. 4.5 hours, I wanted to make sure she got home safely. Oh, man. Yeah.
So, yeah, she...
But
the thing is, because we both started to cry. Yeah. I cried just the thought of leaving her. And then she cried because I was crying and she didn't want me to leave.
Yeah.
And so we just extended the time another week.
Yeah.
And
remember that time when I said, leave your clothes, like, because she had to come back home to check on the house and stuff. And I said, well, leave your clothes. And then when she got down the road, I said, she could have left that shit and not.
No, she was on live and she went in the car. She said, y'all, hold on. I'm going to go see if she left anything. And then she came back because I heard her on live.
She said,
left them, y'all. She come back. He was like, wait a minute. Maybe she don't want this shit.
No more. I did. I said, maybe she don't want this shit. And then I said, well, did she take her she probably got about 5 toothbrushes at home. She don't need this shit either. So I said, come back.
I was supposed to come back, I think, like 2 days later.
I came back the next day.
Is I could not be without her.
Yeah. And we like that now. You know your friend, Nikki.
I could not be without her. And the thing about it is, I mean, one time we was FaceTiming and she said, I want to tell you something. But I said,
I just wanted to tell her I felt her spirit. She thought I wanted to say I love her.
Yeah, she did. She said, but I want to tell you, I think I love her.
Because she felt like it was too soon.
Yes. I think when she said, I love you, I said, how do you know? You don't know if you love
and
me.
And I said, I love your spirit.
Yes.
I said, I love
your
spirit.
But that was a good answer.
Yes, because it was true.
Yes. You know Pink Panther. Pink Panther, you know me. You know me.
And she was like, oh.
I was like, go ahead and say it again.
And let me tell y'all this. So remember earlier when she said, like, to write long paragraph? I wrote a paragraph explaining to her about...
I don't think it's necessary that you tell that.
Yes, I do. I explained to her what I meant when I said... Where are you going?
I'm going right here to give me some cake.
I was explaining to her what I meant about loving her from my spirit. And you know what? She texted me back and said, okay. I can't stand.
Mercedes, they're going to that short and sweet shit I'm telling you about.
She's like,
Okay. Whew. Yes. Okay. I can't stand that shit. Okay. Yeah, so okay. Yeah, she did. But she did say the okay A-Y. If she did just the okay, baby. She did spell okay out.
Oh, though. I didn't say K.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Man.
But then, you know what? That's what I had to look forward to waking up. I knew there was going to be a paragraph waiting for me.
She had her talker.
You wrote a book? Somebody said you wrote a book.
Yep. Not the okay. That'll make me. Yes. Yes. You brought that some more of that dry ass cake.
I know you better get up off mine.
Yes, she did, Frank. She did the okay. After my 50 line sentences.
How are you just going to come here co-signing? I didn't know you was in here. Hi, Frank. Hi, Frank.
Oh, man.
I don't know.
I'm not going to write a book about my life. My life is not, I haven't done anything, you know, spectacular that people just need to read a book of mine. No. I'm just glad that I'm at peace.
See, I told you you were going to be my friend. I know, I told her that. Nikki had told me, she said, when she met me, was that, you know.
You going to laugh and say, hey.
She said, you going to be my friend. I'm like, what if this girl going to sit here and tell me I'm going to be her friend? Look, we friends. What is it? 10 years later, we friends.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, but I appreciate you so much for being in my life.
I appreciate you being in mine too.
Yes, Nickelodeon.
And do not switch up on me.
Yes, we love you, Nickelodeon.
Wow.
So, she said yes.
Anyway,
you done made me your friend.
I'm just glad we locking this.
Except life. For life.
For life. Yeah.
Yeah. Like I told them yesterday that, because somebody was saying, had it already been in me, you know, as far as liking women, like, has it always been in you? Maybe, you know, somebody, you know, you just never acted on the impulse. But no, that's not the case.
Right.
It's not the case at all.
You just love love.
I love love.
And you love the feeling of love.
Yes, and I love you.
Yeah, and it wasn't about seeing me as a gender, but right. Just a person.
A person.
Yeah, and a lot of people need to realize that instead of putting people in categories and in boxes, you know, I just feel like people are missing out on love because they're so busy labeling and putting things in boxes. So
does that make sense? And sometimes when I forget, no, because I don't sound right.
You don't forget. Yeah, you don't forget. It's just, you know, you just not accustomed to a lot of things. Yeah, I mean, as far as the lifestyle.
Girl. Well, not that. I mean, just like, when she do this and stuff, like, girl, yeah. I'd be like, don't do that. You acting like a whole girl right now.
She could get on a whole woman over
I
here.
I do.
So but you know,
so like that one time in the parking lot when you got to walk and you did like that and I was filming you, remember that one?
But it was a joke, but our friend.
Damn well, baby.
I got a twist in my walk.
She did that well. Baby come walking, y'all. Baby,
but I ain't never said I wasn't who I am. I
parking
just
lot. She come walk across the parking lot, she say.
Is that my baby? She said, I'll do that.
Get my baby back.
What's going on, Blazing D? What's happening? That's Daniel, baby.
Hey, Daniel.
We don't have no kids. But if y'all give me a hold of Regina,
if she meets Regina King, then I'll consider.
She'll consider adopting. So y'all supposed to have been working on that. What y'all waiting on? what y'all waiting on? You made it to Mississippi yet? Blazing D, you made it to Mississippi yet? All right, you need me to get it? Hey, y'all, been working. You all right, Journey? Journey, did you get a hold of Regina and Mary yet?
she wants a 2-for-1 special, huh?
I'd be surprised if either one of them. You know, I dreamed that they came in a box. I did. I had a dream that they popped up in the box. No, blown child again. Okay.
Sound like you need a new truck.
Probably so. I dreamed that she came in the box under
a different name.
Mm-hmm. And then somebody say, answer the box. And I answered the box and she popped up right there. I fell on the floor.
You can't do that, baby. You can't do that.
I did. I dreamed I fell on the floor. You're going to blow your opportunity.
She'd be like, well, I was supposed to be in here for 2 minutes.
You spent
1 minute of it on the floor.
No, my truck ain't fixed. My truck in the shop. I don't know when it's going to be ready. That's the only reason why I'm home and on live. Other than that, I'd be at work. What today is? Yeah, I'd be at work.
Tuesday.
I'd be at work. I work Sunday through Thursday, off on Friday and Saturday. So, I dreamed that. And then I woke up asking for some damn chicken. Well, the chicken came true, but Regina still ain't popped in the box.
Well, sounds like you with the right person then.
Steve Harvey on TikTok. Yeah, I know he on TikTok, but see, he don't see me. I don't know why he don't see me. So, same for my truck, waiting on parts. Okay.
Yep.
Wow. So.
But that's that. That's our story. That's part of our story.
Yeah.
Part of our story.
Miss Park said, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm about to send him your page. Oh, okay. I'm trying to hold it together. I'm very frustrated. It's a frustrating thing. Just be glad you're not in no snow. So maybe do a duet with him. I don't want to force myself on nobody.
Yeah.
My cousin works for Steve. Let me see what I can. Oh, come on, D.O.D. D.O.D. Come on, D.O.D.
Wait a minute. What, Steve? She can say, I just said he worked for Steve. I just say Steve Harvey.
It's on the way. Okay. Driving truck can be stressful. Mm-hmm. He just getting into it, and he's one of the ones that said that if it wasn't for me, you know,
yeah,
I helped him along the way. He's another guy that said I helped him along the way, and it feels good that a guy says nice things about me. It feels real good.
Okay. So it might be there Thursday? Cool.
Okay. I appreciate you.
Yeah, thank
you. Hey, what's going on, Smitty? So, I just try to give my all to whatever situation I'm in. It can be stressful out there on the road. Just don't let it get to you too bad, because you gotta understand you're driving for other people. You met him in person. Okay. Just understand you got other people that you got to look out for. So you can't be, you know, frustrated because, you know, you got five people, you know, around you while you're driving. So you got to make sure your head on straight. And then when you pull off on the side of the road, get your 10-hour break, you get it all out, get outside, kick the tire, kick the door or whatever. Just make sure when you start driving again, your head is straight. So, next time I'm meeting Green, I'll be in Illinois. Okay. What's going on? What's happening? Anybody got anything?
They were saying that they wanted our meet and greet, but we don't do meet and greet.
Oh, yeah. Hey, Nani.
I haven't seen Lele on here today.
I thought I saw her earlier.
Well, I mean, it's like just, this evening.
It's just that it's the third time this week.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. That, again, when they change, depending on whatever side it is, they're supposed to change both. Whatever side they bust, they're supposed to change both sides. But if you don't tell them that, they're not going to do it. So, Stern, of course, you know, steel tire bust, they're supposed to change both of them. But make sure that they do both. But if it's on the trailer, that's just what it is on a trailer.
Yeah.
Any and everything goes when they come on the trailer.
Tell them your advisor said. My advisor said.
I drive 34 years again. Patience is what you need to do. Yeah, patience. Yeah. Yeah. The key thing is that you want to get back home safely.
The same way you left.
So
in one piece.
Tractor, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, the tractor, you just you gotta make them change all tires. I'll make them change my tires. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and see, let me tell you something. The key thing is don't wait till you get back to the yard. Go to the Love truck stop. Call the yard and tell them that you need the tires to be changed, and they'll change all the tires, and then you deal with that when you get back to the yard. But at least your tires are changed.
Again, your advisor said.
Yeah, I drive JB Hunt for 2 years. Okay, JB Hunt, they still, speed limit, is that 60, well, 55? It was 55. Did y'all go up to 60 yet? So, did JB Hunt go up? Because I be passing y'all up on the road. yeah, let's see.
63.
63? Oh, okay, okay. Okay, but that's how you do that. And then the thing is when you need the tires, anything you need done to the truck, get it done at the truck stop. Mm-hmm. Read the petrol tire check, told them they, but didn't change it. That's why you need to be at the, park could be on that side of the road.
Hey, Chrissy.
I tell them people, I ain't moving till this stuff is done the way I see fit and safely.
But then they
know that about me, though. Yeah, but they know that about me. Yeah, that shit'll stay on side of the road.
Be stern.
Yeah.
Be stern.
Yeah. But if you talk like you don't know what you're talking about, they'll run all over you.
Yeah, I was going to say, be stern, no kiki and kaka, and just be stern and let's handle business.
Yeah. Oh, man.
But don't tell him like I know.
Yeah, can y'all just say that I have COVID and my nerves are spinning shot? Okay, okay. But that's the advice I can give you on a truck. Is that I want to give it until I see y'all. We'll be to check us back in. Check back in tomorrow at 5:30. We'll be here again.
Yes.
We'll be here again. Just hold on to 5:30, same time.
Same channel.
Yeah. You on your own truck? No, I don't. No, I don't. It's too much responsibility. And I done got up to the point that I've been driving 27 years. I'm tired. I'm trying to get into something else. So, when I told them about my Southern Tahoe experience, it's a different tune. Yeah. Mm. Yeah. Yeah, that's how you do them. You beat them at their own game. Yeah, that's how you do them.
They say, yeah.
Yeah, you gotta get them, because if you talking like you don't know what you're doing, they get over on you. I remember I fixed some lighting on the back of the trailer, and the guy came, and he detached everything that I did. But I had already had it recorded and sent it to my boss. I said, now, if they charge you for it, I said, you fight this, because I had already fixed it. They came in behind me and detached it and refixed it, so... Yeah, which trucking do you recommend for a new driver? Tanker. I would say go tanking. Go do tanker. Tanker is the easiest thing to do. Tanker box trailers is good, but it's a lot. Tanker is the easy thing. What's going on, sick B9? What's going on? You out there on that road? Please tell me you're not in that snow. Oh, man. Yes, Lord, but I was having a nice day until some guys be trying me. They'll do that too. I agree. I'm looking into tanks right now. Tanks are easy. They're very easy. Only thing that they require is that you have 2 years experience. Mm-hmm. That's the only thing that they require. You get 2 years experience, you can drive a tanker. I would say get into oil. If you get into oil, you don't have to worry about having a hazmat. Hazmat is good to have. I am, but it's nice here in Colorado. Okay. Hazmat is good to have, but with oil, you really don't have to have it. You just still have to have your twit card and stuff like that. And keep your license up to date. I got 2 years now. You can get into any tanking industry you want to get into. They'll hire you on the spot. I promise you. And you will love it. Oh, man, I don't want to drive nothing else but tankers if I got to drive. Oh, man. But I appreciate your videos and stuff when you teaching them and schooling them on some things. So they got some hard heads out here that don't want to learn. They don't want to listen. They don't want to take heed to some knowledge and people spitting out here. And speaking of, I ain't always had a porta potty.
No, you don't. Mercedes, I want to drive a truck now.
I had a bucket back in my day too now. Yeah. Because I know you were going in on somebody not having a porta. I ain't have a porta potty. I had a bucket. Had a bucket for each one. The number two stayed outside. But you know, I got a porta potty now.
I'm chilling.
Oh, man.
She said with heels on.
And you can do it. You can do it. I promise you can do it.
Lashes and all, girl. Be out there.
As long as it's not in outdoor. Yeah, that's number two. I kept that bucket outside. Mm-hmm. Shit. But you know, I love driving. I do. It's just I done got to the point. I'm tired now. So if I can get in the hot shot, I will. But I don't want to do no other driving than that. Have you ever thought about being a therapist? You would do a great job. No. Not a therapist.
That's why we're saying we do a
coach.
Couples coaching.
That's it. I ain't nobody's therapist, you know. Because everybody don't respond the same way, you know.
It's like people are more open doing it this way.
I thought about buying my own 10 years ago, and Walmart called, and I forgot all about buying my own. Yeah. But Walmart is kind of strict, huh? Why ain't Walmart kind of strict? They strict. Do you recommend going through a... Yes. Go through the academy. You learn a lot in the academy. Yes, I will definitely request that you go through academy.
But what did you do? How did you
get in? I went through the academy.
I know, but what was it that you went through?
What you mean? Tri-State? What, the name of the place?
Yeah, the first place that you went to determine that's what you was going to do.
Oh, Job Corps. Job Corps.
But then you went to Tri-State.
Tri-State semi-trucking. I don't know if they still do it, but that was back in 95, though.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's been a minute. It's been a minute.
Yeah, it's been a minute. And a lot of what I went through back then, they got some new stuff now. So I would advise going through the academy. It don't take but maybe 3 weeks, y'all. 3 to 4 weeks. Try instructing instead of driving. A lot of people don't like to listen. They don't like to listen. That's why I'm not a trainer.
Or to a female, huh?
Yeah. That's why I'm not a trainer. And me, these men, older men, they don't want to tell them, especially me, they don't want to listen to me telling them what to do. Shit, I'm trying to tell you.
Have you ever been in that situation where they ask for another trainer? Like, have you ever trained somebody?
Mm-mm, no.
Never trained nobody?
Mm-mm. Oh. Well, I did, but I didn't get paid for it.
But I'm just saying, you trained somebody.
Yeah, I trained about four people.
Okay, but I mean, did they have a problem with it at the time or no?
No.
Okay.
The guys, they were, you know, and they did their own thing once they got by themselves. But
I'm sure of that, but I'm just saying at the time that you was actually training them, like, did it come across that they have a problem with you training them?
No, because my training is I'm down to earth, you know. I'm talking to you like I'm talking to you right now, you know. I ain't finna use no big words, and I ain't finna tell you to, you know, I'm just down to earth when I'm telling you how to do it, you know. And I find the easy way, but the correct way, if that makes sense. Does most companies require a CDL permit beforehand? You gotta have your license, yeah. You have to have your license. When you go to class, when you go to the academy, from when I went in 95, you go to the academy, and you get your permit, and then you go to the driver DMV, and then you take the driver's part, and then they give you your license right then. But no job is gonna give you a CDL job with a permit. They're not gonna let you do it like that. Hey, Kylie, what's happening?
Is that Kylie that used to ask all those questions?
Yeah. How do you know what companies pay road decent route? I would say Google it. But most companies are about the same. They pay by the miles, pay by the miles or pay by the load. It's all the same. Mm-hmm. It's not like it was, you know, in 95 where you get paid, the more you drive, the more you get paid and all this stuff. But this day and age, everybody get paid the same, unless you're owner operator.
Oh, we will. So please keep us posted on coaching.
Yeah.
It's no money in the beginning.
No, it's not. It's not.
Concrete mixer class be only great pay.
But that's it, y'all. We finna get out of here. I'm tired. I want to go. Is the Oval coming on tonight? Trick card. How do you obtain getting one? Just pull up. Let me see this. Hold on. Let me see some.
No, she's not gonna buy her own truck. Like she said, that's too. You got to maintain it, so that costs money.
Yeah,
it's better when it's somebody else's truck.
Pull up Twit Card application. Go to your Google and type in Twit Card application. And press on that, and it'll take you right through it. It'll walk you through it. Twit Card application. And I believe you have to set up an appointment and all that good stuff. Understand that they do fingerprint, FBI, background, they check your DVR. They do all of that. So just make sure all your stuff is in order. If you got warrants out, just know when you carry your ass down there to the DMV, you're going to get arrested on the spot. they ain't gonna tell you online. They ain't gonna tell you on the phone. But if you got some warrants and you ain't took care of that thing, you can't get your ass down after the DMV. Have some bail money. That's all I'm saying. Just have some.
Well, don't show up.
Oh man, because I'm farsighted. I'm not nearsighted. It when I put it up, no, I don't like
it.
It's
a Homeland Security check.
Yeah, it costs $225. Well, it was $136 when I did it, but again, I've been having mine for years, so it may be that price. It was $136 when I did it.
I see it going up because I mean I can understand that because mm-hmm. You got yours when you was what in your 20s.
Mm-hmm.
30s?
20? I was 25.
Mm-hmm.
I was 25. That was so
we had leftover chili for dinner.
That was so long ago. 25? So long ago.
I can't even remember 25.
Ooh, I can remember 25.
I can't. I can't.
Yes. But it's good to have your trick. It's good to have your hazmat. It's good to have your fingerprints. Because at the end of the day, when it's all said and done, you in the clear. And when you're handing them people your license, when you're handing them people your license, it's a proud thing to know that everything that's behind it is in the clear.
I made beef stew with oxtail. Yes. Oh Lord, baby, be
yes.
Look, you know, make
who was that stand on, Queen? Yes.
I knew she was gonna zero in and be quiet on that one.
Ooh. Oh man, so. But my license is my livelihood, so I try to keep that intact. And medical, and keep your physical and stuff intact. So make sure your blood pressure is all right, because if you go take your physical and your blood pressure is high, they ain't gonna pass you. So I'm telling you now.
Just make sure when you go in there to when you get a physical and mm-hmm. stuff like that, when you get in there, sit down and relax. Relax, because what a lot of people don't tell you, I remember a doctor told me one time that your blood pressure, because being stuck in traffic and stuff, make your blood pressure go up.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Yeah, I'm putting it in here for you. Yeah. Did you get that? I put that in there for you. That's how you get your Twit Card. But did I see live this morning? I enjoyed it. Yeah. Consume garlic for a week. For what?
Blood pressure. If you have high blood pressure.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, but then you walk
what
around.
What you mean?
But like, you walk around a spoonful. Like, you know, or not a spoonful, but actually eat garlic. Not anything that has to do with garlic or garlic.
Mike always eating garlic.
Yeah, but
he have like this big clump.
Right, but then you go around smelling like a number two special. You don't want to smell like that.
No, seriously though. But
that seeps through your skin. It does.
No, I'm saying you can walk around and just eat that.
You can eat garlic, yes. But then it starts to seep through your skin, and that's what you smell like.
You're welcome, Cloudy Gigi. You're welcome.
But Nickelodeon, she won't be doing that. First of all, she don't have high blood pressure, but she won't be doing that.
Doing
she
what?
Won't eat garlic. Garlic, baby.
I don't eat garlic, so you ain't got to worry about me. They have pickled garlic. What's that? Eat garlic with tongue.
There you go. Drink a lot of water. Here we go. But yeah.
I ain't got no high blood pressure. I ain't got to worry about me. No, I'm just saying other people. I'm talking about.
She was talking about if you go get your physical.
Go get your physical.
Just to
they're
make
not gonna
sure.
pass you. Yeah, you they're know, not gonna pass you if you yeah. have if you have high sugar and high blood pressure.
Mm-hmm.
They're not gonna pass you. And I think they make you wait a week. And I'm only doing
to try it again.
I'm only doing it because I know my cousin.
Somebody said just keep the vampires away.
Oh man, garlic pills works as well. Okay, I didn't even. They got pills for every damn thing. Huh?
They do.
What about vision? Your vision is fine. If you wear glasses, they gonna pass you. If you wear hearing aids, they'll pass you. Just got to be able to hear that whisper when they say, "What am I saying? 1, 2, 3." Then you're supposed to say, "What am I saying? 1, 2, 3." There you go. And then they pass you. They pass you there. But that's it. That's about it, you know. Why are you smiling? So beautiful. Aww. Yeah, garlic peels are available. Okay. Baby, go give me some garlic peels. I don't know what that's for.
She's not gonna smell like a number two special not around me.
What's a number two special?
You know, just when.
What is it?
Can't say.
Is it food?
Yeah, but I'm not gonna say because it's I don't want to offend anybody.
So is it a burger?
You can be a water burger. Yeah, you know how water burger smell? How it smell? You know how that smell?
Allergy season is crazy.
You know how water burger smell? How you come back and in your car the next day and it still smell like that?
Yeah,
that's what you gonna smell like.
Nah, not me. Shit, not me. We gotta call moms. We gotta call both our mothers. He say musty.
Oh, you almost made me
choke. Oh, man.
You almost made me choke. I'm with you, Jay.
Would you say, it's taking about 3 months to receive tweet when you apply. Okay.
Okay. And probably now due to the pandemic, would you say, is causing the delay?
Yeah.
You say you know what I'm saying.
Yeah. Damn. Yes. So, DOD, get on that for me. I'll be expecting a call. Oh, man. But we appreciate y'all being here. We finna get out of here again on all our platforms. Just go on our bio, click the link tree, and it'll take you to all our platforms that we're on. And,
So I know.
Yeah. Just take what you can and leave the rest.
If it don't apply, let it fly.
You know.
We're not licensed therapists.
Yeah.
So we just go by life experiences or what we would do in a situation.
Yeah.
We've always said this disclaimer, you guys. I know some of y'all guys feel some type of way because you done spent about $40,000 to get your title and stuff, but I mean, this is just life experiences is the best experience.
Yeah,
I understand you do that professionally, but you know, we're just talking about we just do this just to come in and you know get that.
I know what she told me what it was. I know, but I don't understand it. I'm just saying, she told me what it was, but I don't understand it. So you just have to break it down to me in a long text.
You know what, Novi. If you look on the link tree that's in Swing's bio.
In your bio.
Or in my bio. If you click on that link tree, it has each social media platform, and what the links are, and if you press on it, it will take you straight to it.
Yeah. Because they got Instagram, Facebook, all that stuff.
Right, so it's Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, all that. Spotify,
she
whatever.
Said, she said, okay, thank
you.
Yeah, she said, okay, thank you.
Yeah.
So...